Hello, this is Shesha Jalam from Astrogate Mysore. So today let us understand and continue with the combination of planets. So we are now discussing about the combination of Sun, Moon and Saturn. A tough combination, because we all know that Moon-Saturn combination is a tough combination. Sun-Saturn combination is a tough combination. Father and Son, that is Sun and Saturn. The intercombinations are also not that easy. The Amavasya combination itself is a tough combination. I have spoken on Amavasya. The positives of Amavasya, I have spoken of the combination of Sun and Moon very close to each other. I will put that in the end screen. So please watch that video also. Amavasya combination is also a very important combination. So when we see the major karakatvas, that is the significations of Saturn, Moon and Sun, and combine them to understand what sort of a person will this give out and what sort of a result a person will get if he is having this combination. So let us understand. Saturn usually is the epitome of patience. You know, it is logical interpretation because of your past experiences in life. So you will have a lot of experiences in life. Because Saturn means only after a lot of experience does the Saturn start to work. That means after you are 35 years or 40 years, your Saturn will actually mature and give some result. So it will be after that particular middle age. So Saturn means patience and logical interpretations because of your experience. Then the Moon gives the flow of thought, the language, the versatility, the vocabulary. I have been telling all these karakatvas when I am talking about Moon. Individually, please go through the Moon's karakatvas, that is the significations of the planet of Moon. Very early in my classes, I have been doing it. I think the 10th class or the 5th class, I think you will be getting these things. So, till now we have done 600 and some classes. So, in all those classes, you will be getting small pieces and bits and pieces of Moon and its karakatvas. But if you want the whole part of Moon to be understood, go to that particular class of significations of the planet Moon and go through the whole class, you will understand it in detail. So all those significations of Moon, like communication, language, fluency, flow of thought, talkativeness, marketing, business attitude, all that will join along with Saturn in this combination with Sun. Sun, grit, confidence, cruel, rude, harsh, you know, but unbiased. It's a very honest. A ruler, a king, will stand tall and will always think about the best for the situation, best for the whole society. That is what is Sun, and that's why Sun gives fame, and it can also become argumentative if it is a little, posited in frustrative positions. You know, Sun, when it becomes frustrative, is that it sits in a bad dikbala, that is directional strength is less and it is weak in the chart, and it sits along with Saturn and Moon, then it goes through a little bit of a malefic combination of, Saturn and Moon. So, putting all this together, a person can become an excellent lawyer, an advocate. So, in all the epics, this is the first point which has been discussed in detail, that a person can be very firm and very clear with regard to his ideology and his way of interpretation. So, he can be a lawyer, an advocate, but in this combination, if the Saturn gets combust, then unnecessarily, the person can easily get into, he can be coaxed with believing things. So that means he gets easily, he believes and can be fooled. That is, he trusts people very fast. This particular combination of Saturn, Moon and Sun, that particular native will not have trust issues. He will trust very fast. But repetitively, if he goes through failures because of the trust issue, he will then get a problem in trusting people. So, that is a problem in this particular combination. So, That is, if you trust somebody and if you, somebody fools you with regard to, you know, intentionally he fools you with regard to financial things, then what will happen? That you will lose your savings and unnecessarily land in poverty. So there is a chance that suddenly a debacle, suddenly a person can lose everything. So when you are getting into the, when you know that you have this combination and you are getting into the dasha bhukti, that is the mahadasha and the antardasha, that is the major period and the sub periods of sun, moon, Saturn, sun, Saturn, moon, Saturn, moon, sun, Saturn, sun and moon. You have all moon, sun and Saturn, six combinations. If you have these combinations, you need to be extremely patient and do not take any decisions in panic. Okay, let us go into another point here. Saturn becomes the, you know, it represents the Mooladhara chakra, the lowest of the chakras. And sun represents the highest of the chakras. I'm just doing this one thing for this particular combination. It's not that I'll be doing chakras for all the combinations. Just giving you a hint as to how this has to be linked. The Mooladhara chakra and the Sahasrara chakra with the Agneya chakra, that is the sun, moon and Saturn, are now sitting in one place. Sun and moon are very conscious planets. And it's the, if these both are weak, sun and moon are weak, Saturn is extremely strong, then the consciousness will all get sucked up into the Mooladhara chakra. And what does it do? The Mooladhara chakra is nothing but lustfulness, craving, craving for fame, craving for money, craving for position, unnecessarily wanting to become extremely famous or rich or wants to be noticed in society. That getting noticed in society without doing the hard work, you know, wants to stand next to the politician, wants to get recognized. He'll always be telling that, I know him, he is my brother, he is my cousin. So this kind of relating yourself to rich, famous people or people with influence or in politics or in, as a king, is a kind of, you know, I'll not call it that these people are slave of them, but still, they have a tendency to get associated with famous people so that they can also get their work done. So this is when the sun loses its ego and the moon loses its identity. And this combination happens. And these people can be, you know, unnecessarily getting into painful relationships. And once they get into it, they fall prey to it and then they, it becomes an obligation to them. So what all businesses these people can do? They can do, they can be very good in animal husbandry, particularly all those four-legged bovines, all those ruminants which eat grass, like the cow, the buffalo, the horse, the goat, the sheep, the donkeys. So they can do very good business with this. They are very good in this. So they can also be good in dhatu, and that is material, minerals, particularly minerals and metals. So these people can be very good in goldsmith, working under a goldsmith. It's not that they will all become jewelers, but if sun is very strong and Saturn is weak but is well posited somewhere in the 10th house, these people can become goldsmiths. But usually if all the three are taken equally placed, then these people can become very good alloy specialists like metallurgists. So finally, this particular position, people should know that they should be able to contain and control anger. Because when Saturn loses its strength, that means a person has lost his patience. And if moon gains the strength, that means he is mentally strong. And if sun loses the strength, he is very weak with regard to his confidence and his soul strength. That is what we call as the ego. So when ego is down, patience is less, mental activity is high because the moon is strong. A person will unnecessarily keep thinking. Overthinking will become a huge nuisance. So the best thing to do is to focus on one thing and keep that thing as your life skill and also as your daily bread earner. Do not get into too many things with this combination in the 10th house. People will, you know, be wandering into this and that and that and this, and they'll not be able to finalize as to what they actually have to do. So get into one thing, be a specialist in that and stick to it. Stick to routine. If you stick to routine, because all these three planets are routine oriented planets. The Sun, extreme routine. Saturn, very, what we call as persistent. And Moon may be a flexible planet, but if you are able to catch hold of these two planets, the Sun and the Saturn, Moon should be coming with you and you should be able to be successful in life. So thank you very much for today's class.